works and friends of life, and the sacrifices, the ultimate sacrifice, they made in service to our country. We're here today to honor our heroes and sheroes. The sacrifices they made to our country are but a beacon of hope for us as well. And as we gather today, we also know that there are more than just family members of servicemen and women here, that there are those who come on this day to honor their loved ones who may have passed either this year or in time past. And so as we gather, let's do so with a pause of reflection. Dear source of all goodness, we ask your blessing upon this day as we bring to mind those who served our country throughout the armed forces. Accept our thanksgiving and gratitude for their sacrifice and the sacrifices of their families as well. For you are our refuge and strength, and you have shared with us in sacred passage that neither space nor time, life nor death, can separate us from your love or from them. Be with us now as we celebrate in earnest our loved ones and those who dedicated their service to our country. And we ask this in your name.
Hold your family and friends.
Memorial Day is that time to connect with our history and values by honoring those whose service were their ideals. We join many across the nation who at this very moment are gathering to pay tribute to their loved ones,
lighting candles, laying down wreaths in observance of this special day.
The service members we honor today come from all walks of life, but they share several fundamental qualities. They possess courage, pride, determination, and dedication to duty. Qualities needed to serve a cause greater than themselves. Now, of course, many of them did really ask to leave home and join a distant family. And yet there were just as many who did.
They didn't go to war because they loved fighting. They were called to be part of something bigger than themselves, as we said. They were ordinary people who responded. They heard our nation's call. And since the first shots at Lexington and Concord were fired in a Revolutionary War began, millions of American women and men came and have answered the nation's call to duty. We gladly award them service medals, brave, honored, like the eternal king. that we could live free. Those of us many generations later, and those yet who are still serving, know that we hold you in all of your thoughts. To the families of servicemen and women, know that you've lived through difficult times, and that you have all the support and understanding. And those who are here to pay tribute to their loved ones, perhaps not even associated with the armed forces, like the flame of our candle of remembrance, may the love you shared continue to bring brightly in your hearts as well. As our nation pauses today to remember those in the military who've given their lives for our freedom to enjoy, we come together with grateful hearts. We must never forget that the highest appreciation we can show now on Memorial Day is not just to utter words, but to live by them. Daily, we too are called in various ways to live our values. Though we as individuals wonder, are we up to the challenge? I think we are. Service to one's neighbor and community, respect for others, integrity of intention, and personal courage are now what we have to live by. And so let our acts become living memorials, resulting in liberty and sisterly love and peace that is offered by them. May the Lord protect and bless all who serve in our armed forces and continue to do so, and their families. May the Lord comfort our wounded veterans and those who care for them, and may the
daughters of carrying our everlasting wreath out to the reflection pond, we will have tasks, and then we have what we call the presentation of the wreath.